years of 2009, I was training for the Vancouver Winter Olympics in Park City, Utah, and sustained a traumatic brain injury. You know, that resulted in me having to relearn how to do the most normal, simple things. Learning to walk and talk and swallow. Competition was no longer a reality for me. I had this identity, and my identity was a snowboarder. I needed to find a new identity and a new path. Yeah, you know, it was pretty amazing to make it to where I did make it to in snowboarding, and you know, that was to the very top. I became one of the very best competitive snowboarders in the world, you know, beating Sean White, beating, you know, all the top guys. In getting to that place where I was winning all the biggest events, it was like a dream come true, and it was like, you know, the most amazing feeling I could ever imagine to get to that place. Snowboarding, you know, has definitely changed, but it hasn't changed that much since I was doing it. And, you know, it's changed in the sense that, you know, in slopestyle, these guys are, you know, doing more corks and more spins on the jumps, and, you know, starting to add some style into it, you know, at certain points. And, you know, the half pipe's a lot alike of when I was doing it. And, you know, the trick I fell on was a cab double cork, and, you know, that's kind of still, you know, the pinnacle of half pipe riding now is a cab double cork, is what these guys are doing. And, you know, they're adding maybe another 360 to it, but, you know, not much more is happening. And, you know, we just saw in the X Games, Danny Davis won, and he won because of his style and, you know, bringing his style back to the sport. So, you know, it's almost moving in a different direction where it was all tricks and spins and flips, and now it's like Danny's starting to pull it back to where it's really about the style and being more technical and, you know, not doing as much acrobatic, but making it look cool. Yeah, you know, it's so hard to know what the future holds for snowboarding, and to be honest with you, I have no idea. I could not tell you. You know, I would not have been able to guess that Danny would have won these past X Games, and you know, I thought Sean was gonna take it because everyone knows Sean White and knows how good he is, and you know, he has all the double corks, and Danny kind of just laid it to him and was like, it's not about double corks, it's about style. And you know, progressing the sport in that way, I think, is so good for snowboarding. And you know, it's so amazing to see that, you know, Danny was able to do something that no one else was doing. And it's like, that's why I love snowboarding so much, because it was so different. It's like, you couldn't just go and jump on a snowboard like you can jump out on the soccer field or play basketball. It's like, it's very different. It's very unique, and you have to have a lot of style, and that's what it was all about. And, you know, that's what Danny's showing. It's still all about is, you know, self-expression. It was a very kind of, you know, it was a certain mindset that I had to get to that place where I was able to be training for the Olympics, you know, to be able to get to the X Games and to get to that place. And, you know, I had to go into it a certain way, and I had to have a certain kind of mindset and a certain drive and, you know, a certain passion. Obviously, I had the passion, but it takes a certain work ethic. And it wasn't just like I rolled out of bed one day and I was able to do this stuff. It's like I had to work my ass off, and I had to put the time in, and I had to have that mindset where I was like, I'm gonna do what it takes to get to this place, and I'm gonna, you know, work as hard as I can, and you know, I'm gonna put in the extra hours, and I'm gonna do this because that was what I wanted. And you know, I started doing well at it, and I saw the possibilities, and you know, I knew with enough focus and drive and work and energy that I'd be able to get there. Yeah, so that was on December 31st, and I don't remember any of that day. I don't remember waking up. I don't remember driving up to the hill, getting suited up, putting my boots on, strapping in, anything from that run that day. Actually, that entire month, you know, the following month of January, I don't have any memories of, and there's nothing, you know. They flew me in the helicopter down to the University of Utah, and I don't remember that. And then I was in the University of Utah in critical care for 27 days, and then in acute care for a week and a half, and then in February, they flew me to Denver, to the Craig Hospital, a rehab hospital, and that's my first memory, was going into that airplane and getting flown to Craig Hospital. It's been a long, long time, and I'm still in the process of it. I'm still healing, I'm still getting better, and you know, it was crazy there at the beginning, and I see these videos of these parts that I don't remember of learning how to swallow again and walk and talk and, you know, do all these things, you know, starting to eat food. It was like, I didn't know how to do it. And so like, that's crazy to watch. And then once I started getting better, they had me do these exercises, like walking on a treadmill. And usually you're running on a treadmill and it's at like 5.8 or whatever the speed is. And I was at 0.01 walking on this treadmill. And if you go to a treadmill and put it on 0.01, it's like,
yeah,
it's like a snail's pace. And so it's like, looking back to that and then, you know, seeing where I am now, I think it's, you know, it's awesome. And, you know, I think it's great to be able to share this message and, you know, that anything is really possible. And wherever you are and however far down you fall, that you can come back and you can heal from whatever issue it is that you're dealing with, whether it's a brain injury or, you know, wherever your struggles might be. If you put the work and you have that energy and you have that motivation, you have that drive, because it's been the same thing for me as it was in professional snowboarding. And you know, that's how I got to the top of professional snowboarding, was with all those things. And that's how I've, you know, come back and recovered from this brain injury. So we started the Love Your Brain Foundation, obviously, after all of this happened to me, because of, you know, I'm gonna talk about it more tonight, but how powerful it is to love your brain and really kind of the meaning behind loving your brain. And you know, when you see this for the first time, when I heard it, it was kind of like, yeah, love your brain. Like, I didn't know what it meant. And you know, you hear love your brain and whatever, but it's actually something that, you know, is very healing and it's very good for you. And you know, to love your brain and to not allow those automatic negative thoughts in your brain, the ants, we call them. And you have to kill the ants, because when you have these thoughts, and we all have them, you know, when you do bad on a test or when you mess something up, or you know, maybe when you crash your car, you're like, I'm such an idiot, I'm so stupid. The other day I dropped my phone in the toilet, and I'll talk about that tonight. And you know, I could have had those negative thoughts coming into my brain, but instead it's about not allowing those and stopping those from happening, whatever it is you might be dealing with. No negative thoughts. Oh, you know, that part of my life is over. You know, riding, you know, competitively and, you know, doing tricks and hitting jumps and riding the half pipe, you know, that's no longer for me. And I've accepted that. And you know, that's not where, you know, my passion lies anymore, is doing that stuff, but rather, you know, riding the powder and being in the backcountry and just enjoying the mountains. And along with that, you know, spreading this message of loving your brain and why it's so important to do so. So no more with the competitive and freestyles. This, you know, what I'm doing right now, right here, this is what I have worked so hard and I have given so much for the last 4 years, is to be able to do this, and it is so special. I don't quite know how I'm able to swing and how I'm able to pull it, but I'm able to really live an awesome, special, special life.